How are you, 26? Welcome back. This is the second lesson. Still, we are dealing with East Africa community. Last lesson, I analyzed about the collapse of East Africa. Now, today, I'm going to explain about the revival of the East Africa community. Now pay attention. From its collapse in 1977, the East Africa did not exist for 22 years. From its collapse in 1977, the East Africa community did not exist for 22 years. In 1999, it was revived again by signing a treaty that established it. Then the treaty came into force in 2000. It means that after its collapse, East Africa community was revived in 1999. Remember, I told you that it was collapsed in 1977 after there was a different reason which causes East Africa community to collapse. I remember the first reason was the misunderstanding between Mwalimu Julius Kambarage Nyerere and Idi Amin Dada, and so many reasons. Then the treaty came into force in 2000. Today, East Africa community consists of 6 member countries. Remember, the first East Africa community, there was only 3 countries, which is Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania. But currently, it consists of 6 member countries. The countries are Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, Burundi, Rwanda, and South Sudan. Its headquarters are in Arusha, in Tanzania. Then the president, Benjamin William Mkapa of Tanzania, Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi of Kenya, and Yoweri Kaguta Museveni of Uganda signed a treaty on behalf of their people of their countries. These 3 peoples decided to revive this East Africa community. Currently, I've said that currently it consists of 6 member countries, but during this revival, it was only 3 peoples who decided to revive it. Who are they? It was Benjamin William Mkapa of Tanzania, Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi of Kenya, and Yoweri Kaguta Museveni of Uganda. They signed a treaty on behalf of their people of their countries. The Republic of Rwanda and Burundi accepted to the East Africa community on 8 June 2007 and became full members of the community with effect from 1st July 2007. South Sudan joined the East Africa community in April. It means that the newest member country, the newest member of East Africa country, of East Africa community is South Sudan. Objective of establishing the East African community. Objective of establishing the East African community. These presidents, Museveni, Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi, and Benjamin Mkapa, they had a different objective, which they convinced them to establish this organization once again. So the first one, to foster greater cooperation and understanding among the people of partner states. To foster greater cooperation and understanding among the people of partner states. It means that they decided to revive this organization so that they can make a good cooperation between these countries, which are Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, and other members of this organization. The second one, to promote free trade of goods and services produced in East Africa among member states. To promote free trade of goods and services produced in East Africa among member states. These countries, they have different commodities. For example, Kenya, they have magadi. Tanzania, we have tanzanite. Uganda, they have copper. So we can cooperate to share these things so that we can promote, we can make our country, we can make our country rich and to save our citizens. Another one, the third one, to provide common service in railways, airways, harbors, and ports. The fourth one is to provide wider and more secure market for products produced within the community. To provide wider and more secure market for products produced within the community. In these three countries, all six countries, we are producing different commodities, different goods, so that we can secure them if we have a good relationship among the member states. And the last one is to facilitate free movement of the people in the member state. To facilitate free movement of the people in the member state. For example, a Kenyan can travel to Uganda, then can travel to South Sudan, and South Sudan can travel to Tanzania, so that we can promote the good relationship and we can live in a peaceful way. This is the end of my lesson. Thank you for listening.